Hey, YouTubers. Hope you guys are doing well. I am having fun. It's Saturday again. Got a chance to get away from work. And I got my polypropylene panels. These things ought to be awesome. Should be able to hold any weight of tools. And don't have to worry about them absorbing too much. Boy, I wish I could talk. That's that glass of wine I had last night. Should be okay with absorbing any moisture down here in the basement. I've got a dehumidifier, but this polypropylene, the reason why I got it, and it's a little pricier than I wanted to pay, but the problem is when you're using the old pegboard stuff, and that's what I have here in my engine storage area, was in this house when I moved in. It's the old stuff's pretty good. You know, it's almost like a glossy finish. But man, if you let the humidity get up in this room, it's going to, of course, absorb it, and then it's going to break down. So I don't want to go there with that. I got some other places where I got the cheaper stuff was in here. And this is a little bit smaller than the quarter inch. It was 3/16. And you can see it's starting to show some wear. Like, look at here. Look at this. See how it's not straight. It's thin. That's the first strike against it. The second strike is when it gets moisture in it, and the moisture even goes away, it warps it. And this stuff is real junk. Eventually, I'll replace this someday. But anywho, can't work on the engines. Just got to keep on keeping on. The shelf system, the problem I have here is I want to clean this off really good and then finish it, but the stuff I put on here, this real super hard stuff, which is like, it's like on the order of like a Varathane poly coat, tough coat, you can't really put it on without great ventilation. So I'm not going to be in here sucking up bad fumes and stuff. It's not worth it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this on hold and get over to my shelf project. And what we got is, because, you know, this basement is full of trash and garbage. We're not hoarders, but we got a lot of junk we need to organize, you know. I mean, all this stuff's laying all over the place. And what happens is, of course, you can't find stuff. And that'll drive you mad, right? Because you'll be looking for something, you won't find it anymore. So, solution to that is I'm going to put some along this wall, because I got, you know, I got about 18 feet, so I'm going to utilize this space, and I'm going to put some nice shelves in here. And it ought to do a lot to taking a step towards getting some stuff organized. Hey, listen, I hope you guys are doing good. You know, I was watching 4x4's videos, Izzy's and MBR and Yellow Dog and a few other of them, and Archer and all that stuff. And you guys, man, you know, this is a great YouTube family. We can share ideas out here. We can show each other what we're working on. And, you know, this is all a great media. Thank God we're living in 2017 and we have these tools to network like this and bounce stuff off each other. Because, my God, I've learned a lot of stuff. You know, I think I know a lot, but, you know, learning's an infinite thing. You never, ever, ever going to know it all. And these tips and techniques I get from y'all and stuff like this is a huge help. And I get better ideas. And, you know, that's how I got the idea to go to this polypropylene rather than using, you know, cheap pegboard stuff. Because you start putting some weight on that, and that stuff may come down on you. I don't want it. So, all good stuff. But anyways, I'm going to put this thing on pause, and I'm going to get to work on building these shelves, and I'll have a follow-up video. Hope everybody's doing great. Us Gearhead, man, we rock. Hey, YouTubers. Wanted to show you what I'm currently working on. I now have a little bit bigger basement in this house, so I'm trying to make sense of the storage space, I guess. And probably showed you before, I had a, you know, we get it after a while, you start accumulating a few things. We're not hoarders, but sometimes I accuse us of being borderline hoarders, and we take things, we purge them, we give them to charity, blah blah blah. But still, there's things that come up, like, you know, the wife will yell, oh, we're going out of town or something, and I need to grab the luggage or the suitcase. Well, where are they at? I'm digging under piles of stuff and everything. So I thought what I'd do is come up with a some kind of shelf solution here. So I kind of did some looking around at what other folks were building and tried to come up with something that, you know, wasn't going to cost you an arm and a leg to build, but yet was simple, because people like me, I got to admit, I'm not a wood guru. A good carpenter would definitely teach me a few things. But anyways, I went out and looked around, and I come up with this. Basically, making it as simple as possible is, when you're building your shelves, you got two pieces that are running along two boards. And to show you this, I'll lift this up. You got two boards. And then right near the end, I connect the two boards together with a cross kind of strut. Okay? And then right in the middle of the length, to give it strength, I put one strut. And then near the other end, about a half a foot before the end, I put one more strut. And now I've been using screws for these. Show you what I got here. Is Lowe's or Home Depot, but in this case, Lowe's. Just use these 2.5-inch construction screws, and they did the job. And, you know, just based upon what you need, you get. I always use them all up, and I love them, because if I don't use them all for doing wood construction, I mean, I use them for hanging stuff up and everything else. They're good for like thousands of things. But anyways, going back to this, so you get your length, and in this case, I had a total of 19 feet. So what I did, because I don't like getting, you know, like 16 footers, I couldn't put in my truck. I got a half ton pickup. For those of you that don't have a pickup and you need some wood, you can always rent a truck from Home Depot or Lowe's. I've done that, and it really works out okay. It's better than hiring somebody to do it for you. They charge you an arm and a leg. Unless you really, you know, you're loaded with cash, unlike me. But so what I did was I took my truck up and I got 10 footers. In this case, I got 2, 4, 6, 8. And then 8 on this side, I got 16 10-footers. And then I bought some 8-footers. These aren't quite 8. They're at like 7.6 for the posts. And the backs, I just attached to the wall here, which is a load-bearing wall. I don't think it'll hurt it. I attached one board across the existing wall. And then the other side here, I put my 7.6 posts up, and I put two in for each set of shells. So there are this set of shells, there's two, and then there's two for this set of shells. No big deal. It went together real easily. Now, just to let you know what this is all about, okay, is I went and bought some 15/32, which is nice stuff for what you're going to do with it. And had them cut it. You know, you get a 4x8 piece and you have them cut it into 16-inch pieces, and you have them cut three pieces. And it's really nice. I mean, I could stand on this stuff. I've seen where some reviews where some people are using it for flooring for their homes. I don't know if I'd use it for flooring for my home, but I'm not a floor guru. I wouldn't know. But it works great for putting this storage stuff in. So that's what I did. I'm really excited about it. I got to cut the last piece, and I'm going to do that next weekend, and then it'll be finished. And then from there, I'm going to go back to my my workbench project, which I bought some polypropylene for the hangers and hooks. But this video is mostly about getting these shelves up so I can move all the luggage and stuff and junk and organize. It'll be really great, because I'll be able to move around down here in the basement. So folks, thanks everybody for listening. And I think now that I got this project done, I'm going to take a break. God bless the USA. MAGA, take care, folks. Please thumbs up and give me a like. And if you do and I don't know you, I'll go over and sub to your channel. Thank you very much.